everyone, Pastor Chelsea here, and you are watching The Thursday Show. So thank you for joining us this week. We are in Christmas season outright, and I'm so excited. It's been so fun to see the decorations and the lights and to get ready in this season of preparation and anticipation. And if you haven't already, a great way to celebrate Christmas is to join us through our Advent devotional that we put out as a church. You can grab your copy at the church website if you haven't done so already. But to go along with that Advent devotional and to go along with Christmas, I thought it'd be really fun for each week of December to look at one of the themes of Advent on our Thursday show. So last week we talked all about hope. This week we're talking about faith. Now, faith is one of those words that if you've been in any kind of church setting, you've heard. But faith, while it's simple, is also kind of hard to define. Let me ask you that right now. How would you define faith? If you have a definition that you want to share with us, drop it in the comments. But maybe as I'm asking you to define faith, your mind's just going blank, being like, yeah, I don't even know how to define it. It's so simple, it's hard. And that's very true of faith. But faith is such an important element of what we believe, especially at this time of the year, and such an amazing thing to celebrate too. Today, as we talk, I just want to give a simple two-part definition for what faith is, and hopefully that can help expand your own faith this Christmas season. So for my two-part definition, it's really simple. Faith is assurance, and faith is action. Let's look at those a little bit together. Faith is assurance. In Hebrews chapter 11, known as the faith chapter, it talks all about it. It's a really good one to read. It even walks you through all sorts of Old Testament figures who experienced faith or demonstrated faith through hard situations. And in Hebrews 11, verse 1, it says, "Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen." The assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. It's basically believing that what we can't see is just as real as the things that we can see. And that's a challenging thing to put into practice. But that word assurance has even deeper meaning than that. If you actually look at the original Greek words that were used for that verse, that picture of assurance is more like evidence. Faith is the evidence of the things that you can't see. Your faith is your evidence even to yourself when things get hard, when things are challenging and you're not sure what to believe. Your faith can be that anchor of evidence in your soul that God is still present, He is still good, He is there. I think of it kind of like maybe you've done a home renovation before and you've had, you know, your set of plans of what that was going to look like. I know for me, I just refinished my basement a couple years ago, or not refinished, finished for the first time. And I drew up this set of plans of what I wanted it to look like, and I gave it to the contractor that we were working with, and I had this sense of assurance of how it would look even before it came to reality. I could picture it in my mind. I could see where the walls would be. I knew where the doors would be, and I had this assurance of how it was going to turn out. That's kind of the way we are sometimes with our faith, and that's what our faith looks like, is we have an assurance that even if our circumstances around us look different than we would like, even if we're in a hard situation, we have an assurance that God is still good and that He's going to bring about good things even if we aren't living them out just yet. So the first part of our definition is that faith is assurance. The second part of our definition is that faith is action. Faith by itself, you know, thinking that God is good and thinking that good things are going to happen, that's part of the equation. But if all we're doing is thinking, then we're never going to actually see our faith grow or see our faith in the fullness of what it could be. Faith without works is dead, we're told in Scripture, and that's where the action piece comes in. Because while we think something, we also have to act on it and move forward on it. And if you think back to the first nativity, what a perfect picture of faith in action. So many of the individuals who were a part of the Christmas story had to do exactly that. They had to put their faith in action. Mary had to put her faith in action when God told her that she was going to bring the Savior of the world into the world. She had to put her faith into action by being obedient and by living out 9 months of pregnancy. Joseph had to put his faith in action. When he was told by the angel of the Lord that Mary was pregnant with child, he had to put his faith into some pretty big action to believe that that was true, to still go through marrying her, even though he wasn't the father of the child that was inside of her. If you think about the Magi, they had to put their faith into action. They were trusting Jewish prophecies were true, and they followed a star, in a way it seems blindly, but followed that star by faith, that they would find the baby King Jesus if they followed it. That's putting action to your faith. And faith doesn't usually make sense if you look at it on the outside. It didn't make sense for Mary, for Joseph, for the Magi, for anyone, and it often doesn't make sense for us either. But how incredible that God uses things that don't make sense. How incredible that God uses faith to bring Him glory this time of year and all year round. I wonder for you, maybe you've been going through a season where your faith has been tested or challenged, or faith has seemed difficult to believe, to have that assurance that God is good, or difficult to put into action. And I just want to encourage you. I think if Christmas does anything, it reminds us of where our faith is placed. And it reminds us that our faith isn't our own, that our faith is grounded on someone so much greater and stronger than we are. I like how Martin Luther King Jr. put this. He said, "Faith is taking the first step, even when you don't see the whole staircase." And that's exactly the picture of what faith is. It's an assurance that there's the next step there, and it's the action of actually going to the next step. That's what it looks like for us as believers to put it into daily practice, taking one step after another, even if we can't always see it there, but trusting that it is. In seasons like this, we're either going to grow our fear or we're going to grow our faith. It all depends on which one you feed. Are you feeding your fear by focusing on the negative, focusing on the hard things, focusing on the way things used to be? Or are you feeding your faith? Are you focusing on God's promises? Are you focusing on His faithfulness, on the way He's come through for you in the past, on what His word tells us about His nature and how He loves us? Whichever one you feed is going to be the one that grows and is going to be the one that you're living out every single day. I don't know about you, but I know I want to grow my faith. I want to feed my faith. And I want my faith to be the thing that's there present, even on the days that are hard, not fear. And so guys, we have a choice. If we want more faith, then we're going to have to feed our faith and be putting that into practice. Spending time reflecting on His word, spending time with other believers, growing together in our faith, talking about our faith, hearing stories of how God has come through, trusting Him and spending time with Him in His word. That's how we grow our faith this Christmas. My prayer for you this Christmas is that your faith is assured and in action because it rests on Jesus Christ. Thanks for joining me today. I look forward to talking about Advent some more with you next week on the Thursday show. Have a great Thursday.